So you moved to an open-minded, tolerant, and progressive country that turns very orange once per year during a celebration with lots of drinks, flea markets, and every single person out in the streets. Of course, you need to tell to your friends back home about it, and because you're a developer, they all speak JSON, except for that one SQL guy. But who wants to embed variables like the celebration's name and date into a string in Java? Fighting with concatenation, formatting, and adding an extra validation step, that doesn't sound like fun at all. Lucky you, thanks to an upcoming Java feature, those may soon be the problems of the past, and you can easily interpolate a string and get injection-free and validated JSON that you can send their way. And we'll see there's something for the SQL guy too. Welcome everyone to the Inside Java newscast and happy King's Day to those of you in the Netherlands. I'm Ana Maria Mihalciano, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and today's episode is dedicated to string templates and their capabilities specified in JUP 430. So happy Strings Day to all Java developers.
Hey, Nicola here from editing. Yes, this is what I look like on a stay inside day or week. What Anna forgot to mention is that JUP 430 is already targeted for JDK 21, so you'll be able to use string templates as a preview feature in the upcoming long-term support. Now back to the video.
Are you ready? Then let the fun begin. As developers, we often perform data transformations for APIs that accept strings in formats of JSON, XML, SQL, etc. To deal with this kind of data processing, we employ different mechanisms for string composition. We concatenate strings via the plus operator, or we continuously append a string item with string builder, sometimes writing a POM of append. Some of you will be like, hey Anna, but you can simplify the previous examples by using text blocks to enable multi-lineness. True. Still, to embed the variables, I need to use string format or string formatted, but separating the format string from the parameters can induce arity and type mismatches. How can this be simplified? Many programming languages offer the capability of a string literal to contain text and embedded expressions. At runtime, the embedded expressions are replaced with their stringified values, so the value is being interpolated into the string. In backend code, string interpolation for SQL statements or even JSON is dangerous because it can lead to injection attacks. Imagine some hypothetical Java code for an SQL query that selects all users having a certain role with a where clause. If the query is just a string, it may use the embedded expression role in the where clause, right? But if role has a problematic value, that changes the restrictions of the original query. Then this value would modify the SQL query to return additional results. Sure, there are means to avoid that using the current Java syntax, like prepare statement, but this kind of approach adds more surface-level complexity to prevent the SQL injection. Moreover, as developers, we're also concerned by the input validity. Is this a legal SQL? And making legal states unrepresentable, instead of just representing them first and then validating them. We rarely create just strings and need some kind of validation so often that this should be a core feature, not an afterthought. As we would like to improve both the readability and reliability of our code, we need a template-based mechanism for composing and validating strings. Template expressions can perform string interpolation and can help you compose strings safely and efficiently. Moreover, template expressions can turn structured text into any kind of object following domain-specific rules, like for JSON, SQL, or any other text-based format. The syntax of a template expression resembles a string literal with a prefix. It consists of a template processor like str, a dot character, and a template which contains embedded expressions like backslash name. The template of a template expression can span multiple lines of source code using a syntax similar to text blocks. At runtime, the template expression is evaluated and its template processor combines the literal text in the template with the values of the embedded expression. The template processor is the one that determines the result type of the evaluated template expression. A string literal is processed by a template processor, which has the explicit responsibility for safely interpolating and validating a result, string or otherwise. In case that you forget to use a template processor such as str or fmt, then a compile time error is reported. The JUP mentions three template processors defined in the Java platform. Raw is a standard template processor that produces an unprocessed string template object. SDR is a public static final field that is automatically imported into every Java source file. It performs string interpolation by replacing each embedded expression in the template with the string value of that expression. The result of a template expression evaluated by SDR is a string. There is no limit to the number of embedded expressions that can exist into a string template expression. The embedded expressions are evaluated from left to right, like the arguments in a method invocation expression. Moreover, to help with readability, you can spread an embedded expression over multiple lines in the source file without introducing new lines into the result. The value of the embedded expression is interpolated into the result at the position of the backslash of the embedded expression. The template is then considered to continue on the same line as the backslash. FMT also performs interpolation, but it interprets format specifiers which appear to the left of the embedded expression. The format specifiers are the same as those defined in the java.util.formatter. The FMT template processor is an instance of the template processor class java.util.formatprocessor. FMT uses the default locale, but you can create a template processor for a different locale by instantiating the class differently. So far, I talked about situations when template processors return instances of string and throw no exceptions. The SDR and FMT template processors act like the template processor is an object accessed via a field. Although SDR and FMT are useful abbreviations, they are just instances of the functional interface string template processor. A template processor that implements the string template processor interface directly can return objects of any type, not just string. The return type of the template processor is specified by the first type argument of the string template processor. Furthermore, a custom template processor can perform validation and throw checked exceptions if processing fails. The exceptions thrown by the processor are specified by the second type argument of string template processor. As many modern APIs accept strings in different formats, how can strings with embedded expressions be processed in a way to return, let's say, JSON or XML? There is a wide variety of libraries that help us deal with JSON, XML, or other formats, and most of their object types operate with strings. These existing projects can benefit from the versatility of the template processor API and define their own template processors. For example, to have a simple template processor that returns a JSON object, one would need the instance of the functional interface string template processor, which takes a string template and returns the JSON object. If the interpolate method call occurs without checking the validity of the input, then you're at risk to propagate injection vulnerabilities into the JSON result. Before calling interpolate, you should check the template's values first, and if a value is suspicious, throw a checked exception, like JSON exception. If the custom processor throws checked exceptions, then you must handle processing failures with try-catch statements or propagate the exceptions to callers. And that's it for today on the Inside Java Newscast. If you like these videos, do me a favor and let YouTube know. In 2 weeks, Nikolai will be back to entertain you with a new episode. Subscribe and ring the bell so you won't miss it. As this episode appears on 27th of April, when is King's Day in the Netherlands, I wish you all Happy King's Day!